so kitty hawk on the bike lanes on your wall. You will always see me Johnson from the time that you were small. No schoolroom kept you grounded while your thoughts can get away. You will take him up and tie the monster wings against the brush strokes of the day. Are you there on a tarmac with the winter in your hair? By the empty highway doors, you'll stop and stare. Leave the oil drums behind to the one care. Drifting with the tailwind when the runway came in sight. Clouds came up to gather us and the cockpit turned white. When I looked, the sky was empty. I suppose you never saw the landing lights. Are you there? In your jacket with the grease stain and the tear. Caught up in the slipstream of the dare.
Thank you.
dancing from the walls of the Bastion. Through the streets of Paris runs a sense of the unreal. The kings have all departed, the servants are nowhere. We burned up all the mansions in the name of Robespierre. Oh, we wait to see the day begin. Our time is wasting in the moment, wondering why, wondering why it echoes through the lonely palace of Versailles. Just no place to go. Bonaparte is coming, your days are numbered. We live hand to mouth, yet we wait to see the day begin. Our time is wasting in the wind, wondering why, wondering why it echoes through the lonely palace of Versailles. Its purpose incomplete. It speaks inside the cheap red wine of cafe summer nights. It's red and amber voices, call cars at traffic lights. Why do you wait? See the day begin. Our time is wasting in the wind, wondering why, wondering why. Strike the pose. But, you know, this becomes gay disco at 10 o'clock, so... By your beauty, and it drew me to this place. I felt the chill of mystery with one foot on your shore. Then there is some to go where no man had before. Or maybe I was so blind, perhaps the wind spoke true. I believe those rumors then was travel sometimes too. In Antarctica. What the powers might be to cause a man to go, mindless of the dangers out across that virgin snow. Seduced by this ambition, I so easily forgot the hopeless quest of Shackleton, the dreamlike death of Scott. Or maybe I was snowblind, perhaps the wind spoke true. Stories that us travel sometimes do in Antarctica. Antarctica. Or maybe I was snowblind, perhaps it set my will. Something of my innocence goes wandering there still in Antarctica. One day, there was a Hungarian gymnast in room 217.
just finished like nailing her apparatus to the ceiling, and she was actually in mid-flip. So, you know, her feet were actually above her head when he broke down the door and charged in with like some prune juice on a tray, which he hadn't delivered. And she caught sight of him out of the corner of her eye and then sort of did the flip, landed on the bed. But in the moment that she was in midair, she'd fallen in love with him hopelessly. Bang, she landed on the bed, and she decided she'd be really cool, so she sort of like lay there in a debonair way. And he felt hopelessly in love with her. So being the way that God made him, he charged straight towards the bed, but he knocked it through the window, and she sailed out the window and landed in the car park. And this caused grave physical damage to her, but he didn't give up because he loved her. He went down, mended her broken bones, and over a period of 6 months, they made mad, passionate love when the doctors weren't looking in the hospital. All of this is not in the next song, but I wanted you to I wanted you to get, you know, the gist of what the song is all about. Stop me at any time you think I'm going too far. playing in success round English folk clubs. Seems like every time I play this song. And then I got so bored I didn't play it for 20 years, and then I started playing it again. She took 19 harmonicas and sat down to play on a doorstep, saying, come back to my place, I'll show you the stars and the signs. I followed her into the black lines, while the window frames peel and flake, and the old Jewish face behind the lace, keeping on trying to get to see what's cooking. Baptist in the park getting late, thinking there's no one looking. And it's 80 degrees, and I'm down on my knees in Brooklyn. My house was a dusty collection of rusty confusion with landings and tunnels. Leaning bookcases and aces and spaces and things. We're 25 Puerto Ricans, Manhattan Mohicans, and little Italian pawnbrokers lead the theatrical lives and their rooms in the wings. Just walk through the crazy alleys while the cops go working. And the ruthless, toothless agents sneak around thinking there's no one looking. Oh. And it's 80 degrees, and I'm down on my knees in Brooklyn. While mumbling apologies for coffee that tasted of rat food, I said that's okay, mine was tea anyway, just ground. She lay on the bed while the radio fell asleep. Records and adverts for birds.
Roach to Moscow!
even though you're a folk singer, and even though you're playing acoustic guitar, you know, every time you see something like Black Sabbath, you think, oh, that could be such fun. Can you imagine? Can I imagine? I mean, this is all I have. You know, it's like, no knobs, no anything, I have this. So a few songs, and that's all I've got. And I see heavy metal music. It looks so great, but one thing they all do is they stand at the very lip of the stage and they sort of leer at the audience.
Go on.
It looks amazing. I'm going to try it. Sails among the clouds, turns the rifles into silver on the border. It's actually it's a little bit of a nostalgia thing because just around the corner from here is Greek Street, and the extremely old people in the audience, and I had a look at you, so I know there are some. We'll know that at number 49 Greek Street, there was a folk club, and it was the most famous folk club that England has ever had. It was called, Les Cousins in French, but everyone called it Les Cousins. Everybody played there. Dylan, Simon, Van Morrison had a residency there, and he was played £3 a night to play at Les Cousins. Amazing. He played there every Tuesday. Jimi Hendrix played there. I was there about 3 feet away from him. One day, someone said, "This guy behind you playing the guitar with his teeth," and it was Hendrix. Every single person that you've heard of, Cat Stevens used to wander up when he'd only written one song, which is called Portobello Road. He used to come in, he was called Steve Adams in those days, and he would play Portobello Road and go off, and who knows where he went. All this stuff happened, and of course, you know, the major, you know, people that you know, Butch Ernst, John Morello, David Graham, were residents and they played there all the time. It's all at 49 Greek Street, it's just around the corner, so I walked past it and I thought, my God, I spent 7 years of my life there. So this is about working in folk clubs in the old days. I'm beginning to think that none of you went there. It's impossible. But someone must have gone to the Cousins, eh?
Look for the shiny heads.
So, because that was my first job ever was to be the con guy. They ran an all-night show, and it went from midnight to 6 a.m. On Friday, midnight till 7 a.m. on Saturday. And in winter, I never saw daylight, because I was doing this thing. And I was living in Lyle Street, just around the corner, in a horrible place, but I thought it was wonderful. I was 19. So this is actually about playing a different folk club. Because I never wrote a song about the Cousins, this is a song about the Bristol Troubadour. But this is exactly the way that everybody played the guitar in about, 1967. song that only lasts for 15 seconds, so if you don't like it, it's gone before you have any cause to worry. Said the apple to the orange, oh, I wanted you to come close to me and kiss me to the core. You might know me like no other orange has ever done before.
Traces of me the sea.
is strong. She sits and waits all night long, just waiting for another day. She'll have to find another way to go. No memory, tell me what's wrong with me. Why am I alone here with no rest? Another night, oh, the ship is not the same. How long has it been, Marie Celeste? Now there's nobody from the crew left. 500 years of they'll never know, never know, never how strange life in dark water can be. They'll never know, never know, never how strange life in dark water can be. Thank you.
the most complicated song in the world. Rainstorm, rainstorm, faces in the maelstrom, huddle by the bottles and channels with a tarantula. Difficult in English. We have no idea what it means to play that to a Japanese audience. Now, I think it's fair. I've done like, what, I don't know, 8 or 9 songs. I think it's only fair to ask you what you want to hear. I'm just checking you don't think I'm wrong. I'm not. Okay, I got one of those anyway. Mainly because the person yelling for it was right in front of me, so I'll do it.
Stirring of the forest, coming unexpected.
got to be upon the outpost, growing like a promise. You'll never know which way to turn, which way to look, you'll never see us. As we're stealing through the blackness of the night, you'll never know, you'll never hear us. The evening sings in a voice of amber, the dawn is surely coming. The morning road leads to Stalingrad, and the sky is softly humming. Two broken tires on fire in the night, flutter their souls to the wind. Oh, I wait in the light for the final approach to begin. It's been almost 4 years I've carried your gun. Follow me along, almost be spring. The flames of the tigers are lighting the road to the land. Softly we move through the ruins that bow to the ground. The old men and children, they send out to face us. They can't slow us down. All that I ever was able to see, the eyes of the city are opening. Now it's the end of a dream. It's your bit again.
there's a certain debate about whether, you know, there's life after death. And I wrote a song, I don't know, one time ago called Life After Death. I actually stole one of the lines from a poet who I've long since forgotten. That's the reason I never recorded it, because I can't find out who wrote the line that I stole. But there are plenty of other lines in it that I didn't stole. And in this particular scenario, Earth is destroyed, and a couple of souvenir Earth people are taken away, blown to pieces in sort of like minute little subatomic particles. And because it's a love song, they fall in love eventually. That's they're put together. So it only has one verse. It wasn't really going anywhere, so I stopped it. But several people have asked for it since. I guess there are people who want anything that, you know, isn't on a record, and this isn't on a record.
Watch this with a couple.
watches light the western skies. Sometimes she thinks she knows them just too well. Other times, not much at all. They live their lives in some romantic spell. Catch each other when they fall. Nothing lasts while she knows. Try to hang on to the past, you'll be burned. Fashions and friends come and go. Everyone travels by road in that turn. She wants to run out while the day meets the night. Far beyond these Midwest towns. She'll be with them till the day she finds a stranger lying in her arms.
Scottish manoeuvres.
The young admirals. Not the wild.
There's
Hippo song.
I was surrounded by the orange Hippo buttons.
Maybe the most hated song I've ever written. I liked it. I must be mad. I don't know. There's a lot of coming and going across the Atlantic Ocean. English pop stars want to go to America. American pop stars want to go to England. And it doesn't always work out that they're famous, you know, where they come from. So Jimi Hendrix, you know, who was laboring in obscurity, came over here and became a huge star. I saw him three times at the Savile Theatre in 1967. And that's when I gave up electric guitar, you see. Today is his birthday, did you know that? Yeah. Conversely, because we got Jimi Hendrix, we sent America Foghat, and they became huge in America. I guess they're not huge here. Recently we sent them Bush, the same thing happened. In return for Bush, they sent us Tori Amos, who was totally unknown, became a huge star here. So this kind of thing that goes on where people have to cross the Atlantic to become stars. Long before any of that, there was a lynching in St. Louis, Missouri in, I think, 1919, which was... No, this is a terrible thing. I mean,
somebody talked too much?
Yeah, interposing history into whatever I say. So there actually was. And they hung a whole... a load of black people, and a young girl decided that it was time to get the hell out of town, and she went to Paris. Within, I think, about 6 months of arriving in Paris, she was the biggest star in town. And I wrote a song about her. I was watching TV late last
last night, the scene transferred at me. Long gone figures came back to life in a documentary. Though I saw them dance for joy, I was sad I missed that show. If I had a time machine, I know just where I'd go. Too late to see Josephine Baker dancing in a Paris cabaret. Born too late to see Josephine Baker, she must have been great in her heyday.
Knows this next song, and if he's anywhere in the building, let's have him. Here he comes, Paul Robinson. There's a huge swing revival happening in America, and I don't know, bands like Red Hot Voodoo Daddies and whatever are selling millions and millions of records. Now, unfortunately, I released this particular song about a year before the swing revival took place. So this is the only swing revival song not to be a hit. But it's pretty much an homage to Django Reinhardt, who is one of my favorite guitar players. Paul is going to be Django Reinhardt during this next song. Tough act. Underneath the clock, carry an umbrella, no need to talk. The man in the humbug, hiding in the fog, will be watching. Oh, get yourself a ticket.
go through the gate at 7:45 precisely, don't be late. If anybody follows, don't hesitate, keep on walking. Take that night train to Munich, rumbling down the track. After half an hour in the restaurant car, look for the conductor and there will be a stain on his tunic, paper underneath the sun. Then you gotta pray that it doesn't look away, or you'll never, never, never know. Inside, on page 27, there's a picture of a bride. Underneath the story of a man who died in Morocco. Oh, memorize the article, word for word. The man on the humbug understands the code. Make sure the conversation isn't overheard, they're around you. On that night, train to Munich, rumbling down the track. After half an hour in the restaurant car, look for the conductor and I won't be a stain on his tunic. A paper underneath the sign. Then you gotta pray that it doesn't look away, or you'll never, never, never come back.
Is on the last album that I released in 1995, which I think is already very hard to find. It's going to become the lost album, I can tell. It's actually one of my favorites, but the 10,789 people who bought it, quite a piece. Well, we're going to do a pop song for you now. Thank you.
strolling through the crowd like her eyes shine like the moon on the sea. She comes and then sends.
Like a winner of a marathon rolling in a field of snow, like a
fit the skating gigolo, looking for a heart to steal. Like a simulated orgasm suddenly becoming real. Like a big yellow tractor going mowing through a field of hay. Like a genie on a tabletop serving through the month of May.
It's Jimi Hendrix's birthday after all. Thank you very much.